She's lost.
Lost her husband.
Lost her way.
And the darker way.
The road that leads into the funnel.
Lost her own.
Found the whistler from the stars.
Eater of dimensions.
The blind piper.
Welcome to another video by Centipede Geek. Today I'm going to talk about the sci-fi original television series by the name of Continuum. I am going to discuss my thoughts and opinions upon episode 8, titled Playtime. And without any further ado, let's go ahead and get to it, shall we? So pretty much what the main elements in this episode, it all revolves around one main thing, is that in the future, there's this sort of technology where we are able to control each other by putting this sort of, I believe, like some sort of memory chip or something like that into someone. We are able to control them and control their every thought and their every action, and you can use them for good, you can use them for bad, and that's pretty much the main elements in this episode. We have Kagame, and Kagame, what Edward Kagame is trying to do, him and the revolutionaries, they are trying to get control of Kiera. They're trying to control her, and in the episode, they're trying to control her, and around the end of the episode, they end up trying to make Kiera kill her partner, and then kill this guy that's involved with like this sort of a virtual video game reality sort of thing. Try to make him kill both him and her, and then what they want to do is make Kiera kill herself. But of course, none of those things happen because Alec, of course, he's, you know, a smart guy. You know, the younger version of Alec ends up hacking their system, and, you know, and now it looks like in the next episode, episode 9, titled Family Time, it seems as if Edward Kagame is now going to go after Alec because he knows that there's only one person that is smart enough to hack into their system and to hack into Kiera, and Edward Kagame knows that that is Alec's character in the sci-fi original television series by the name of Continuum. We had a few other things going on also. As you know, a few episodes ago, Kellogg took, you know, the little piece, the only piece that allows Kiera to get home to her present time, and she tried to get it back, but of course Kellogg wouldn't give it to her. We also had a few other things going on with the whole episode revolved around this sort of, you know, murder-suicide thing, where at first they really didn't know what was going on, and they found out that people were killing, they were murdering people, but they were also committing suicide at the same time. So there's a scene where this girl grabs a guy, and they both back off into a train. There it is, you know, a murder-suicide. And there's another scene shortly before that that also has that. And it all revolves around this sort of, you know, virtual video game that this guy has created, where, you know, you put a helmet on and it allows you to you know, be sort of in this, you know, sort of virtual reality thing. And this guy has made a deal with Edward Kagame about using this sort of technology that allows you to control others' thoughts and control others' actions. That's pretty much the gist of episode 8, titled Playtime, for the sci-fi original television series by the name of Continuum. Overall, I really enjoyed this episode. Continuum is shaping up just to be a phenomenal series. This episode had everything in it. It had action. It had some pretty cool effects. You know, probably one of the best things about it was the whole, you know, virtual video game thing. You know, where it showed they put the helmets on. You know, and then Kiera's character, you know, was out in the snow shooting people down. And then when she got hit, it was as if her system inside of her head was actually hacked and it actually hurt her in real life. And, you know, and she fell over in that scene. I loved that scene. There was also another scene where Alec is trying to, trying to hack into the system, and it sort of goes through like this kind of purplish, yellowish kind of thing, and that was a really cool. So, like I said, you know, of course it's a science fiction series, but one of the things I love about Continuum is all these sci-fi elements. My favorite thing about this episode was the whole element of being able to control somebody's actions and control somebody's thoughts. And that's what the whole episode revolved around. We had Edward Kagame trying to gain control of Kiera. And he did have control of her for a little bit, but of course Alec, you know, came to the rescue and saved her and ended up, you know, not letting her kill, you know, her partner and then kill the guy that created the whole, you know, virtual video game reality thing. So overall, Continuum is shaping up just to be a great series. And I love this episode so much just because of the whole, you know, virtual, you know, video game reality, being able to control someone's thoughts and actions. That was just a really cool sci-fi element that really, you know, allowed me to like this episode a lot. You know, once again, as always, we have solid acting from Kiera's character, you know, the main cop character, both solid actors. Of course, as always, Edward Kagame is once again amazing, steals the show every time he's in it. Also have to say, I forget the guy's name. Let me check real quick and I'll let you guys know the actor's name. He was the scientist. He was the one that sort of actually created this stuff. He's the one that he's one of the revolutionaries, and he sort of created this you know, material that allows you to control people. And if you'll give me just a few seconds, I'll tell you what his name is. His name is, give me a second. His name is Omari Newton. I had to go on Twitter to look. Anyways, Omari Newton also stole the show in this. I loved his acting in the beginning whenever he was, you know, pushing little dials on the little, you know, device, allowing the guy to move and run forward. And they found out that it didn't actually work like they were planned, and they still had to find some kinks, you know, some kinks, and to work some things out in order to let the device do what it's supposed to do. So anyways, overall, episode 8, titled Playtime for the sci-fi original television series by the name of Continuum, was a great episode. I can't wait to see where the series is going to go. Just so you guys know, the series, first season, season 1, is just about over. We only have 2 episodes left. We have Family Time, episode 9, and then episode 10, titled End Time, and then that'll be the end of season 1. Season 1 actually comes out on DVD, I believe. It's up for pre-order if you guys want to get it. It comes out in the United States, I believe, March 26th of 2013. I believe it's already out on DVD for some of you guys that live in other places besides the United States. Anyways, though, but for us United States people, it comes out in just a few weeks, actually. So, like, the week after it shows, pretty much the week, you know, a few weeks after the final episode airs, you can buy it right then. So that'll be really cool. Overall, I can't wait to see what the finale is going to be like. I mean, Continuum. Overall, I'm pretty satisfied so far, so I can't wait to see where it's going to go. Anyways, that is my review for Episode 8, titled Playtime, with the sci-fi original television series by the name of Continuum. Make sure to like, comment, subscribe to my page below, and I'll see you guys later with more episodic reviews of Continuum.